I'll be speaking about the making of the synthetic Indian drums. It was conceived and designed by me about 6 years back. I started on this project. I'm going to explain to you in brief how I came about doing this. Somewhere in 2010, September, I was checking out for some information on the internet. I saw some videos that depicted horrible cruelty to animals in making leather shoes. The scenes of the video disturbed me very deeply. I felt very sad and miserable about the plight of animals at the hands of human beings. I was not using leather, but I realized at that point that being a singer of classical, vocal, Carnatic music, I was using the Mridangam for my accompaniment, and I realized that they are also made of animal skins. I was very depressed. I felt very sad that I had to use animal skins for my own benefit. I'm an ethical vegan, and I felt it was morally wrong, and I had to stop using that instrument for my own use. But then the question was, what to do next? The first thought was to stop performing, that is, stop singing vocal music on stage. But then an inner voice told me that, what's so great about it? If you don't perform, no loss to the world of music. But then an inner voice told, do something. If you mind, you can do something, is what my inner voice told me. But I was really scared. How to do something that had no precedent? Nobody has done anything of that kind in the past. And the enormous task ahead was simply mind-blowing. Nevertheless, over a period of time, this inner voice became stronger and stronger. And then I thought, okay, let me give it a good, hard try. So what I did is, to start with, I just Googled for synthetic skin, because the traditional Mridangam used animal skin. I Googled for synthetic skin, and I found a large hand drum, which is called a bodhram, which had a synthetic skin on it. I went to a Mridangam maker who was my friend. I knew him well. And I gave him the bodhram, which had imported, which had the synthetic skin on it. Asked him to remove the skin and make the drum head for the Mridangam that I was planning to make using synthetic materials. He tried it out, but it failed miserably. So I came back home, worried, depressed, and to start thinking what I should be doing next. One thing that became clear to me was at the time that this project, if I were to do, I had to do it alone. I had to find the right materials, the right processes, all by myself. I wouldn't get anybody's help because nobody had done anything of this sort before. So I started looking at what could be done next. Then I started working on the drum head. One of the important things in the case of the Mridangam or tabla or pakwaj or khol, all these instruments, they have a central, the drum head has a central black portion which is called by different names. It is called karanai in our South Indian terminology. It is sometimes called gab or masala and things like that. That element is the one most critical element, that is the black circle on the drum head, which is traditionally made using boiled rice and iron oxide powder applied in layers to the drum head. It is that which gives the characteristic sound to the drum, the Mridangam or the tabla. The reason being that the sounds become very harmonic when you apply such a application, dark application on the drum head. Technically, it is called loading. So when you load a drum head with a certain mass of heavier material, it starts producing harmonic overtones. All that I knew was that this principle would apply, and then I started making the drum head. I started making a drum head in the most simple form. It looked like this. The drum head was constructed with using thread running through the periphery of the drum head, and hooks were attached to the wooden shell that I purchased, and then I started experimenting. But what about that weight that Karine has talked about, the black patch that appears on the drum head? And that is the one which was really problematic. I tried different materials, and all of them miserably flopped, failed. I worked for days and nights, working through midnight, sometimes through the entire nights, working on different materials as to what could be used for the central portion of the block. The white thing you see is also a similar material. It didn't work out that way at all. So I was very disappointed. I spent many sleepless nights. Didn't know where to go further. In this state of mind, one day I went to the market to buy some materials. I just happened to see some material there. I took it home. I thought I'll try this material out for this application. So I opened the container of that material and then applied this. It was like a paste. And then I had applied it on the drum head and went to bed in the night. I used to do my experiments after the evening because I had to go for work in the morning. So this project was going on a part-time basis after I come from office. So night I did this and went to bed. Early next morning when I woke up, I just tested the sound. Oh, voila, wonderful. I had discovered the material which would work for this application, producing nice sustained tone. So I had got the basic idea now. I could make a drum head somehow with thread and hooks, and I had an application, that is a material which I could paste over it and which could produce a mridangam-like sound. But the problem was this material, what I got, was very sticky. If I put my hand, it will stick to the hand. If I use a tool to make it, it will stick to the tool. So I had to figure out some way of making the karane with this material. Of course, that's a big story. I eventually figured out how to do it, and I started working in this way to go to the next step in my research. Now, this clamp initially was crude. It has sharp corners. So later, I modified it, and it was a good clamp that I could use. So I used this clamp to attach to the drum head, and when I tensioned the drum head, placing it on the wooden shell, I could get a reasonably working system for my tuning, and I could easily tune at all points to the desired level of accuracy that I wanted. I only had to improve the system. Next, I shifted over to a fiberglass shell. Because till now, I was doing my experiments with the wooden shell, but I didn't want to use wood. The reason being that wood needs cutting of trees, and I had two main preliminary objectives. One is to avoid cruelty to animals, and the other is to be eco-friendly. I didn't want the trees to be cut. So when I shifted to the fiberglass shell, I had again lots of problems. The fiberglass shell with this drum head worked fine, all right, but when the temperature changed, the mridangam lost its pitch. There used to be variation with temperature, and it lost its pitch. So I went to the fiberglass fabricator, asked him what can be done. They said, I don't know. We don't know. You have to tell. So again, I had to understand the chemistry of the fiberglass, how it's going to work. And I did quite a good amount of study and found that maybe if I change the chemical composition of one of the ingredients of the fiberglass, I may get a better result. I tried changing the chemical composition of the fiberglass. The fiberglass, as you may know, has a glass mat and a compound called resin. So I had to change the chemical composition of the resin. And when I did that, I experimented. I found that the temperature performance was really very good. We didn't detune with temperature. How did I do that? So I put the mridangam in a AC and in the AC room, change the temperature to -3, -6 degrees. And then initially it used to, the pitch used to be low, getting lowered by 20 hertz, 30 hertz. Now it just became 1 or 2 hertz in a, for about 6 degrees of change in temperature. So the drum head became stable in terms of not only mechanical stability, but also in terms of varying temperature, humidity. And what about playing conditions? So when I started using this clamp system, I found the stability improved, but there were some problems. So after again experimenting for months, I discovered that you can solve this problem by making certain changes in the tuning procedure of the drum head. So I discovered what procedures are required to make the drum head stable, remain in pitch, even when you play hard, even if you play for hours together, you do not lose pitch. I discovered the way the tuning has to be done so that this could be easily be achieved. In this process, I made thousands of recordings of data, pitch versus temperature, pitch versus intensity of playing hard, and how to tune the instrument so that these problems can be avoided. So it also achieved my objective of having a lightweight, and obviously once it was lightweight, it would be travel friendly too. Now one thing is that the stream mridangam, as I called it, synthetic rhythm Indian mridangam, which I called in this mridangam, this invention. This mridangam is an engineered product. What do you mean by that? It is to precise dimensions, and the processes and the tools are all controlled by the method of manufacture. So here I use tools for making all the components. All these parts are made using machines and tools. For example, the fiberglass shell is made using a fiberglass tool. And the covers, those parts are made of plastic through injection molding. The drum heads are made using laser. That is, the drum heads are cut using laser. The clamps in the drum head are made using tools. So everything is made using industrial processes and tools. So when you make with tools, you know that they'll be identical to one another. There'll be no difference at all. So that way, I could make my manufacturing very efficient, and I could scale it. If required, I would add more manpower for manufacturing. I would create additional tools, or I would ask the vendor to work overtime to make more products like this. So the manufacturability and scalability was also addressed during my design. And then this is the how the fiberglass drum mridangam is looking like this now. Now going back again to what I set forth, it should be cost effective. So this is because of the materials that are used, which are done through industrial processes. My cost is also lower. So now we can have music that is really divine without cruelty involved, without cutting trees. Having done this, I started manufacturing this product. I founded a company called Karunia Musicals in 2004. I started developing in 2004. And the product was released in the November of 2015, last year. So this product I launched in November. And I'm very happy to say that it has already been in the market. The artists have appreciated it. So we started manufacturing. I'm very happy to say that this sound of the mridangam, its convenience it offers in terms of lightweight, easy tuning, accurate tuning, pitch stability, cost effectiveness, all these have attracted the mridangists to use this product. It has been played already in hundreds of concerts, both India and abroad. And I have a vision. The vision is to make Karunia Musicals as a global player supplying ethical and eco-friendly musical instruments. Today, we don't have to kill animals for making music. We don't have to cut trees. So that's the state we are in. And I can definitely say that this work of mine has been a pioneering effect in that direction of making divine music without cruelty and environmental damage. Thank you.